Welcome to the Grace Cup Ministry. This is the day that the Lord hath made. Rejoice, I said rejoice, and be glad in it. I don't know about you, but I'm glad to be here today. Praise God, hallelujah. Praise God. And today we have with us the man of God, Dana Walker, and he's with Agape Love Ministry, Bishop Clifton Jones. And also we have Matthew Clemens. He is their minister of music all the way from Chicago. And we welcome him to the city of Sandusky. Amen. Let us have prayer. Praise God.
Let us pray. Oh, Father God, we come. We just give you praise in the name of Jesus. Oh, God, we lift up your name this morning because you are worthy, God. We just come to say hallelujah. Hallelujah. You are mighty, God. Glory, you are great, God. Hallelujah. We just give you praise. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we come in the name of Jesus asking you to touch today in a mighty way. Father, somebody right now calling up on your name, Lord. Somebody didn't sleep last night, Lord. Just going through troubles and problems and all those things, God. But we know that you are God that sees all and hears all, because you say you are the God that healeth thee. Yes. So God, we ask you to touch those that are sick and afflicted right now, those that are in the hospital, Lord, in nursing home, Lord, wherever they are right now, we ask you to touch, heal, and deliver in the name of Jesus. Father, we ask you to bless this program as it go over the air today, that somebody might hear a word from you. Father, we ask you to bless the man of God as he come forth with the word, that somebody might hear a word and give their life to you. Lord, we give you praise and we give you glory for the great and mighty things you're going to do in this program today. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Amen and thank God. Hallelujah.
Amen and praise God. Praise God.
Thank you,
and
Lord.
God is doing great and mighty things.
Amen.
He says, call on me and I will show you great and mighty things. And now let's hear from Matthew Clemens. I love you, Jesus. Do you love him today? And following that, the man of God. God bless you.
greetings to all of you, my Father's children. We bring you blessings on behalf of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. First of all, let me give an honor to God, who is the head of my life, to my pastor, Bishop Clifton T. Jones, in his absence, who's the senior pastor of the Agape Love Ministries. For the sake of time, brothers and sisters, let's go right to the word today. I'm excited about the word that God has given to me. If you could, turn with me to the 18th division of Psalms, beginning at the 6th verse, and we're also going to go to the 46th division of Psalms and the first verse. The text reads in the 18th division of Psalms, "In my distress, when seemingly closed in, I called upon the Lord, and my cry went to God. He heard my voice, and out of his temple, his heavenly dwelling place, my cry came before him into his very ears." We jump over to the 46th division of Psalms. In the first verse, it reads, "God is our refuge and our strength, a mighty and impenetrable force in the times of temptation, a very present and well-proved help in the time of trouble." And the word of God is already blessed. If I would choose a subject today, I would choose the subject, life alert. Life alert. When I look at this division of Psalms in the 18th chapter, it is a division that was penned by David. He penned this at the time where the Lord had just delivered him from the hands of his enemies, from the hands of Saul. And so he was, from his heart, explaining how he felt at this time. If I take you back to the text in the 6th verse of the 18th chapter, it reads, "In my distress." The word distress is broken down as a state of adversity. And I know in our lives, brothers and sisters, that many times in our lives we do come against adversities. Amen. If I speak for my own self personally, I know day in and day out, the devil comes at me with adversity, especially when you're walking the walk and you're talking the talk and you're living the best you can. There will be adversity in your life. But David encourages today in the text when he says that he cried out when he was seemingly closed in. I know there's been times in my life where I've been in situations where I felt like I was closed in. I was backed in a corner. All the doors had been shut. All the windows had been closed and there was no way out of my situation. But like David, I had to call on the name of the Lord. I chose the topic Life Alert because if you ever watched commercials, in 1987, there was a company founded and they were Life Alert, the company. This company, in all their genius, came up with a device that would allow elderly men and women to live at home. And in the case of emergency, they could hit a buzzer and the buzzer would alert the police station. It would alert a counselor, it would alert the ambulance, it would alert all those people that they would need to come and give them renderance of help. The Lord was telling me, he said, "Son, there's a time that when you're in trouble, you call on me, and I'm just like the life alert." So I asked him, I said, "Lord, why is the life alert so necessary?" He said, "Elder Walker, when you look at some of the situations in your life, when times and things are going good, sometimes you forget that you need me. Sometimes you think you can do this thing all on your own." Now, the great thing about the commercial, the marketing and the advertising of Life Alert is as they would show the elderly people, there would be the good times in their life where they felt like they could live on their own. They could do things without any help. But then something catastrophic would happen in their life that would render them helpless. If I'm just speaking for Dana today, there's been some times in my life where I was living pretty good. I thought I was ahead of the game. I thought there was no struggles in my life. But then something catastrophic blindsided me. In the commercial, there was a woman that fell, slipped in her bathroom and fell. The most famous marketing at that time. She said, "I've fallen and I can't get up." And at that time, she had to use her buzzer to call Life Alert. I know there's been some times in my life where I've fallen and I couldn't get up. There were some times that I fell that I thought that I could do it on my own. Not like the commercial. The lady immediately grabbed her buzzer and she hit it. And in the airways of Life Alert, a counselor came on, said, "Miss Fletcher, I hear you have an emergency. How can I help you?" The Lord told me, "Son, I'm just like the Life Alert counselor. When you're in trouble and you call on me, number one, the first thing I do, I call you by name. I want you to understand that I see your situation, that I see your problem. No matter what else is going on in the world, when you call me, I will answer." That's what verse 6 is saying in the 18th chapter. He said that God heard my voice out of his temple. even though he sits on high and he looks down low, whenever we cry out for him, brothers and sisters, he hears our voice. We might not think it. We may feel alone. We may feel abandoned, displaced. But I'm here to assure you that what David wrote in the text is true, that he hears our voice. Even in his dwelling place, he hears our voice. But we have to cry out. We have to cry out for him. We can't go through our tremendous trials and tribulations thinking we can do this thing on our own. That's not possible. When you fall, you have to have help. This woman in the commercial, she laid by her bathtub waiting for the respondents to come. The Lord asked me a very important question. He said, Elder Walker, what do you do when you're waiting for help? If I think about the commercial, the lady, she just laid there. She didn't try to get up. She knew the situation that she was in. She had no power over it. She knew there was nothing that she could do to help herself. So she lay there in faith, in trust that help was on the way. The Lord said, Walker, when you fall, I need you to just stay put. Help is on the way. As I'm talking to you, brothers and sisters, this afternoon, this morning, wherever this reaches you, I want you to know that help is on the way. Think about your situation right now. You may have fallen in your situation, but just call on his name. I guarantee you he hears your voice, and I guarantee you he's going to respond to your call. If I take you back to the text, it says, David says, and my cry came before him into his very ears. He wanted you to know that I hear you, my son, my daughter. There's no cry that I don't hear. What's even better, there's no cry that he doesn't answer. You may ask me, Elder Walker, how can I make sure that he hears me? The first thing is a relationship. You have to ensure that your relationship is solid. That means you have to first give this body a living sacrifice back to him with praying, with fasting, with going to church, with paying your tithes and offering, obeying your leader, sitting under a covering, being obedient. Those things ensure that every time you pick up the line, he's there. It guarantees a response no matter what time of day or night. There's been some times in the middle of the night that I didn't think anyone was there for me. But those are the times that you feel his comfort. Those are the times that you know when you feel that presence of God overtake you, that peace, that he's there with you. David was doing something in this text over 2,000 years ago that still helps us today. He was letting us know that no matter what your situation, my brothers, my sisters, let me give you an example of what happened in my life. When I was in the hands of Saul, about to be overtaken, God rescued me. I can think about some situations where hands were about to overtake me, and God stepped in and he rescued me. That was the call. God said, I hear you, son. Now I just need you to trust me. As I watched this commercial with the lady, as she lay there, she never wavered in her trust that help was on the way. Sometimes our situation makes us waver. It makes us unstable. It makes us doubt. Brothers and sisters, let me reassure you today, no matter what your situation that you're in right now, don't waver. Don't doubt. Understand that help is on the way. The Lord wants to see, what are you going to do as I'm coming to your rescue? Will you doubt me? Will you curse me? Will you try to do it on your own? All those things will not get the result that you need. Be still and know that he is God. Understand that he's coming, but in that time of coming, still praise him, still worship him, still give him thanks, because even in that situation, he did not let it overtake you. Some situations are brought into our life to make us understand who he is in our lives. Sometimes, as I used to hear my mother say, you get a little too big for your britches, and you have to understand who the maker, who the creator, who the source is. And these situations are good times. If I just speak for myself, those situations in my life brought me back to the remembrance of who he is, how powerful he is, his majesty, his grace, and his just peace over my life. If I move to the 46th division, it says very strong words in the beginning, God is our refuge and our strength. That gave me hope today, brothers and sisters, because refuge is a place of safety. It's a place you can go where nothing else can harm you. God said, I'm that to you, my son, my daughter. I'm that place you can go where it's private and it's peaceful and no one can get to you. And once you're in that place, it says, and I'm your strength. I begin to strengthen you in this trial, in this tribulation, during this time of persecution that we all will go through. As long as we keep living this life, we're going to have adversity. We're going to have trials. We're going to have tribulations. But he said, not only will I bring you in and protect you, but I'll strengthen you. When it feels like you're at your weakest, that's when God is at his strongest in your life. That's when he's doing a miraculous work deep on the inside of you that no one else can see. So enjoy those times that you spend with the Lord. I'm not saying that you have to enjoy what you're going through, but enjoy the time that God is strengthening you and perfecting your gift that he's put inside of you. Later in the text, it said, he's mighty and impenetrable in the time of temptation, which means nothing can touch you. Why? Because you're surrounded by the grace of God. He's protecting you. He's holding you. No matter what the fiery darts of the devil throws at you, they can't penetrate God's arms. They can't penetrate the loving grace that he's wrapped you in. And when you're in that place, that's the place of solitude. That's a place of comfort. That's a place where you know that all things that are going on around you have to still work on your behalf. The scripture says, "For we know that all things work together for our good." Even your bad situation right now, my brothers and sisters, is working together for your good. It's building something in you that God put deep on the inside of you that he's trying to birth back out of you. It says he's a very present and well-proved help. That made me smile. Said a very present. The word present means right now. My brothers, my sisters, think about the situation you may be in right now, the obstacle you may be facing right now. Present means that he's there with you in that situation right now. He's not going to wait to show up tomorrow. He's not going to show up late. Most of the time, he was waiting on you to get there because he knew that would be the road that you would take. He said, "I'm here in the present. I'm here in the now. It's not the future. It's not the past. I'm here with you right now." The next word in the text said, "well proved." I love this word. I said, "Lord, well proved." He said, "My son, it lets you know that my record is still undefeated. Everything that he's thrown at you, I can knock it down. There's nothing that can overtake you as long as I'm in your corner." I would ask you, my brothers and my sisters, do you have him in your corner today? You can't live this life. You can't walk this walk. You can't fight these battles without the Lord in your life. What you may be going through may seem like, "Elder Walker, how can I be going through this and serve God?" Well, I will let you know that to suffer with him means you will reign with him. You can't have the cross. You can't have any of the things in life that he promises you without suffering like he suffered. But he gave us a great expectation that I'm well proved in the time of trouble. I said, "My father, when I look at my times, when my brothers and sisters, my family members, when we go through these times, what's our comfort?" He said, "Your comfort is that I never left you. Your comfort is I'm right beside you. I come in three parts: God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. So when you get me, you get the Trinity. We got you covered on all sides. My brother, my sister, he has you covered on all sides. Nothing can get to you. He's very present. He's right now covering you in your situation. I feel right now there's some situations that you feel like are too heavy. There's some burdens on your back. But I'm here to let you know he's presently there with you. In your living room, in your kitchen, wherever you are, he's there with you right now. You feel like you're all alone? Not so. That is a trick of the enemy. He's there with you right now. We can take trust in what David said, that he's a very present help in the time of trouble. Well proved. That means for century after century, everyone that's called on him, he's met their need. To me, that's exciting because I know of the millions of people in the world that serve the God that I serve. If I call and a million other people call, he's at every one of our doorsteps at the exact same time. He's got a special delivery package of help, of strength, of security. And all you got to do is praise him. All you got to do is open the door and let him into your life. As I thought about this situation and back to the commercial, the young lady, Miss Fletcher, she lay there until the respondents got there. Unable to get up and answer the door, they kicked down the door to come to her rescue. The Lord said, "Walker, I'll kick down the door to come to your rescue. There's nothing that can keep me away from you. There's nothing that can separate you from my love. When you are in my arms, I have you. I got you covered. You don't have to worry about a thing." I'm glad to know that the Lord kicked down some doors in my life. And I'm here to serve you. Notice that he's kicking down some doors in your life also. The enemy tried to close you in. He backed you up against the wall. But the Lord said, "Not so. My son, my daughter, there's no door that can keep me away from you. There's no window that he closed that I can't open. I won't let you be alone. I won't let you suffer. I will not let you go down with the ship. He said, I will pull you out of any situation. And I'm a living witness. I've been in some situations that I thought I could never come back from. But the Lord was faithful. Even when I was unfaithful, he was still faithful. That's the greatest thing about the Lord that we serve, the God that we praise. Even when we turn our backs away from him, he still has his arms open wide for us. And in your situation, you may say, Elder Walker, I haven't been 100% with the Lord. But that's okay. Neither was I. Truth be told, no one's 100% with God, but still his arms are wide. Still, he calls and brings you back each and every time. But you have to call. David said, I called on his name and he heard my voice. You have to call him today. Wherever you are, whatever your situation, I would ask you to do me one thing. Put that situation out of your mind and call on his name. If you focus your praise on calling his name, he'll focus his glory on the solution of your problem. Those two things will go hand in hand. As I look at the end of the commercial, the respondents, the ambulance, the police, the fire department, they got to Miss Fletcher's rescue. She smiled as they came through the door. They had exactly what she needed. They had a fireman, they had a paramedic, they had a policeman. Each one of those people played an important role in her restoration. The Lord said to me, my son, I send all the help you ever need. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. All those things complete the package of your restoration. And the great thing about it, later on in the commercial, you see Miss Fletcher, she's up, she's moving about with a smile on her face. Knowing the worst for wear, the Lord said, I return you, I restore you back even better than you were before the fall. Understand today, my brothers and sisters, it doesn't matter what the fall is. It doesn't matter what you think about yourself. It doesn't matter what people tell you about yourself. They count you out, they throw you away, they discard you. I want you to understand that's when God does his best work. When everyone else has turned their back on you, when the situation looks like it's impenetrable, you are out on the front lawn with the garbage, that the garbage man is just going to pick you up and take you away. God says, that's when I step in, son, and do my best work. When no one else can get the credit but me, no one else will get the glory but me. When they've all turned their back on you, and in this life we live, you're going to have some people turn their back on you. Some people that you love, some people that you trust, some people you thought were going to be there to the very end, whether it be your mother, your father, your sister, brother, aunts, uncle, spouses, close friends, close confidants, there'll be a back turn situation. But I want you to remember that when they turn their backs, that's when God opens his arms to you. Don't get caught up on what people say. Don't get caught up on your situation to where you lose focus of who loves you more than anyone else. The Lord, who sent his son to die for our sins, says, with all that sacrifice that my son made, I'll never turn my back on you. I gave you the most precious gift, my son, to remove sin from your life and give you an opportunity to dwell with me in heaven. So at this point, Walker, I can't let you go down. I can't let that problem overtake you. All I can do now is wait for you to call me. He won't respond unless we call, brothers and sisters. As we close out this service today, I would ask you, begin to call on his name. Understand he's the source of your help. Understand he'll bring you out of whatever your situation is. And as I close my eyes to pray, I'd ask you to close your eyes and pray with me that the Lord give us strength through this time. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you that you are a God of second chances. Lord, we thank you that even in our situations, no matter what they may be, no matter the trial, the temptation, or the downfall, that all we have to do, according to the text, is call on your name and your present, a very present help in the time of our troubles. Lord, we just want to thank you, not for what you can do for us, but who you are to us. We thank you for your grace. We thank you for your mercy. I ask you right now to strengthen my brothers and sisters as they go through their tests. Comfort them, lead and guide them to the understanding that no matter what is going on, you still have their best interest at heart. And you will only bring them to the expected end of good and not evil. And doing this would be so careful to give your name the praise, the honor, and the glory. In your son Jesus Christ's name, amen. Be blessed, my brothers and sisters. Oh.